So I'm going to start with some background. And what I'm going to concentrate today is more specifically about dessert apples, but some of the background that I'm going to go through is applicable to pretty much all Malus species. So apple is a member of the Rosaceae, and the Rosaceae includes many of the fruits and nuts that we all like to eat, as well as obviously rose and some other ornamentals. Apple has a basic chromosome number of 17, and that's not like most of the rest of the Rosaceae. Typically, Rosaceae have fewer chromosomes. We have a draft genome of apple. It was published in 2010. And from that genome, we could see that apple is an autopolyploid, and it appears that it's had a relatively recent duplication of the genome and then aneuploidization. And apple varieties are typically diploid. But if you start screening through selected varieties and germplasm collections, you'll find that there are really quite a lot of triploids out there. They've been selected, I think, predominantly because of fruit size. Triploids are typically bigger. And so a surprisingly large number of triploids are around. As a cultivated species, we think that apple came predominantly from Malus diversae, from Kazakhstan in Central Asia. In this area, there are still wild forests of Malus diversae, and it's been the target of a number of different collecting trips by several different people over the last few decades. So there is Malus diversae sort of spread over the world into germplasm collections recently, as well as the origin of the species. And I've just put a reference at the bottom of the screen there to a nice article that explains how we think apple came to be the popular fruit that it is today. So, apple trees do not come true to type from seed. Now, many of us as kids have at some point tried to grow an apple tree from a pip. It's one of those things that is the pips are very easily accessible. But if you've ever had one of these trees that actually has come to fruit, it's often really disappointing. So you do not get, for example, a Granny Smith tree from a pip from a Granny Smith apple. So Johnny Appleseed did a great job at spreading apple seeds around the US, but most of what resulted actually fed into the production of hard cider and not dessert apples. So apple trees are vegetatively propagated commercially and also at various points in the breeding program when we want to multiply up our selections. So how do we do this? An apple tree is made up of two parts. It has the scion variety, and that's the aerial fruiting part. So typically all those varieties that you know, the Gala, the Granny Smith, the Honeycrisp, Red Delicious, they're scion varieties. And then there's also a rootstock, which is the non-fruiting part of the tree. And typically the rootstock is more than just the root system below the ground. It also is a few inches above the ground, say 8 inches or so, depending on who you talk to. And you can clearly see on any apple tree where the union has been made. The trees are propagated in a nursery, and usually it's done by taking a bud. I think you can see here just a bud on a small section of scion, cutting a notch into a rootstock, and then matching up the cambium layers of the two. What then happens is that the cambium layers fuse, the bud of the scion variety grows out, and that becomes the tree trunk, the central leader. And then the top part of the rootstock is just cut off. So the rootstock can affect many aspects of the tree. The illustration here shows what we typically think of most when we're thinking of the rootstock effect, vigor. And the illustration shows a range of different rootstocks that trees are all the same age. They all have the same scion variety propagated onto the rootstock. But you can see as you go from left through to right, bottom right, the range of vigor going from the most dwarfing M27 through to the more vigorous ones down at the bottom there. Typically, M9, the second most dwarfing one there, is the commercial size of tree. But what the range and rootstocks enables the grower to do is to choose a tree vigor that's more suitable for their own growing environments. So when choosing the variety and the tree to plant, a grower not only has to take into account the scion, but also the rootstock. And the rootstock can impart other traits. It can have resistances to diseases or pests. And also it can affect how soon the tree starts to produce bloom and fruit. So in other words, it's precocity. And some of these rootstocks will induce precocious fruit. So typically, the more dwarfing rootstocks will produce trees that have fruit sooner than the more vigorous trees. I've just put a link at the bottom of that page to a really nice seminar that Gennaro Fazio, the USDA apple rootstock breeder, put together. So anybody who wants to learn a little bit more about rootstocks, I suggest you watch that seminar. Apples have gametophytic self-incompatibility, and therefore they're outcrosses. So simplistically, that means that pollen from variety X will not pollinate variety X. So from a commercial perspective, that means that you need to have a pollinizer variety in your orchard. And so that also, you know, if you have an apple tree in your backyard, you need another apple tree in order to pollinate it. When you're choosing your pollinizer variety, you have to take into account two different things. There are more than 29 reported self-incompatibility alleles in apple. So in other words, you have to make sure that the variety that you choose is compatible to your main variety. And then also you have to take into account when the varieties will bloom, because bloom on a tree can spread over several weeks in any one location. So it's important both from a commercial perspective and also, you know, any amateur growers out there, you have to think quite carefully about which variety you choose as your pollinizer. And this obviously impacts what we do in the breeding program as well. So the second part of my talk is going to focus on breeding targets and also outline of how we actually do hybridization in apple.